Hello everyone, today I'm going to review the M Cosmetics Love Me For Me Powder Compact, and this is not quite as heavy as a traditional powder foundation, but it is more of a setting powder for your liquid foundation or a primer for light days. And so I'm going to talk to you about the shades that I wear first, and when I'm a little darker, a little closer to the NC30 side, I wear Linen 8, but now that I'm a little fairer, I have been switching it up a little bit. I tried Natural 6, but it's a little too peach for me, so I've been using a mixture of Bare 4 and 12 Sand, so I know it jumps a lot, but because my skin is very yellow, I try to match it as closely as possible. Since 6 is too peach, it does look a little bright against my skin, and that's why I use the yellow tones of 12 to neutralize the extra fair shade that is number 4. And now that my shade information has been squared away, I can start talking to you about the powder. Powder is an essential for my everyday routine, and that's where powders like my M, my Cupgetto, and my Armani come in. So currently these are my three favorite powder foundations, and I'll start with the Armani. This is the Lasting Silk UV Compact. I wear this in the shade 4. I'm choosing to discuss this one first because it's now discontinued. Armani is repackaging their products and bringing them back out. We don't know when, probably in the next month or two, but the Armani powder is a traditional powder foundation because it's very buildable. So it is a lighter weight powder considering it is a foundation, but I recommend using it over a liquid foundation as opposed to wearing it alone. The great thing about the Armani is that it has SPF. The M Love Me For Me, on the other hand, does not have SPF. So if you choose to wear this powder by itself, I highly recommend wearing a sunscreen underneath, and you can also prime your skin if you have oily skin by using a mattifying primer like the Hourglass Veil. Even though I do love the matte look, I try not to make my skin dry out around the nose, which is where I usually suffer when I use a mattifying primer. So I also love the Cupgetto. This is a Japanese brand, and this is their powder foundation called Triple Lighting. And I love this one because it's super, super lightweight. So the issue with this powder is that it doesn't really provide full coverage. In fact, the coverage is very sheer to light. It's probably sheerer coverage than the M. That's why I always use this one to set my liquid foundations. I never wear this one alone. It also has an SPF like the Armani, but the reason why I love the M Love Me For Me Compact is, number one, I've dropped it multiple times and the powder hasn't shattered and the compact hasn't cracked or even really scratched, and that's why I think it's such a great powder to travel with. And it's versatile because I can use it for photos, whereas the Armani and the Cupgetto in flash photography, they do tend to give you that white, ghastly face, so I don't recommend them if you're going to be indoors and taking flash photos. The M, on the other hand, photographs beautifully under fluorescent lighting as well as flash photography. I did use it on my bride last week. Her name is Joanne, and she really loved it. And even though she has very fair Asian skin, I did feel that the peached undertones of the Natural 6 might be too brightening for her as well, but it turned out beautifully and she absolutely loved the way her photos came out. So I will try to share those with you once I get permission. Going back to Linen 8, this is the shade that I first used last year when I first started testing out the M products. And I like Linen because it's not too orange, not too yellow. And again, like I've reiterated, since I have been fairer, I have been using Bare quite a bit. And it really does work well over liquid foundation. I feel like it smooths the pores. It has a soft, creamy feel. It's not too powdery. It does kick up powder dust in the compact, but on the skin, as long as you don't over apply, it really does leave a smooth, completely matte finish to the skin. And it stays matte for about a good 4 to 5 hours on my normal skin. It just warms up with my skin's natural oils. Even though I do have normal skin, my skin does produce oils. Everybody's skin does. But I do think that the M powder is great because it is really versatile in coverage. As far as formula goes, I do feel that it's most similar to the MAC Mineralized Skin Finish, and this is in the new packaging style that was just released. This one is Light Plus, which is very similar to Bare 4. The most noticeable difference in texture is that the Mineralized Skin Finishes by MAC do have slight shimmer particles. So it has a natural effect on the skin, but there is shimmer, and I tend not to like powders with shimmer in them because the shimmer in the MSF is a lot chunkier than the shimmer in the Cupgetto. This is imperceptible shimmer, whereas I can see the glitter particles in the powder because it is a baked formula. And I really like the MAC Mineralize Skin Finish, even though it does clog my pores up a little bit. I do think that the M in comparison does not, but that's just my personal experience, and I haven't had very many good positive experiences with MAC-based products, so that's just my point of view. I know a lot of people like MAC products, and that's why for this foundation guide, for the Love Me For Me, if you check out my blog, you'll be able to find swatches of many of the MAC comparisons. So I started at MAC, and I branched out to other brands when I couldn't find appropriate matches for these powders. So every single one of the M powders, there are 24 shades available, whereas there's only, I think, 6 available in the Mineralize Skin Finish. You will find swatches and comparisons between MAC products, as well as comparison swatches between the M powders and other designer and high-end brands. So I do hope that you found it helpful. If you have been looking for a MAC equivalent, to order one of these compacts online. Overall, I do think that the quality is great. I do think that $25 for a compact like this is a steal. Regardless of whether you want to wear it alone or on top of liquid foundation, I do highly recommend giving the M a try. And I will say that when I was at Clinique and I was having a swatch party with the sales associate there, she was really surprised at how well the M powders swatched and looked and appeared and felt on the skin. And I do take that as a very positive indicator that this powder is worth a try, even if you've never heard of M before. And if you have any further questions regarding the M powder or any of the powders that I discussed in this video, I've worn them non-stop in the last 6 months, so you've seen them in a tutorial or worn on my face at one point or another. So again, if you have any further questions, feel free to leave them down below, and I'll try to get back to you as soon as possible. Thanks always for tuning in, and I'll see you all very soon. Bye.